Welcome to Studio Biology. In this video, we are going to discuss the phyllotaxy. Phyllotaxy is also known as phyllotaxis. It is basically the arrangement of leaves on the stem or its branches. The purpose behind this arrangement is that to arrange leaves should get proper or maximum exposure of light. Now, there are three types of phyllotaxy. First one is alternate or spiral. Second one is opposite. And third one is whorl. First of all, we'll discuss the alternate or spiral. This type of phyllotaxy, only one leaf is born on the node. We can observe that at a node only one leaf is there. Now some examples of alternate or spiral phyllotaxy are: this is the first leaf, this is the second leaf, this is the third leaf, this one is the fourth leaf. And if we observe this from above, that is from the top, we'll observe like this. First will be overlapped by third, then fifth, then seventh, and second will be overlapped by fourth, sixth, etc. like this. So there are two vertical rows of leaves which can be observed from above. So this type of phyllotaxy is known as alternate phyllotaxy. Now, another example. This is the first leaf. This is the second leaf. This is the third leaf. This is the fourth leaf. This is the fifth leaf. And this one is sixth leaf. And again, seventh leaf. If we observe it from above, then it is visible that first will be overlapped by fourth, seventh, etc. Second will be overlapped by fifth, eighth, etc. And the third will be overlapped by sixth, ninth, etc. This type of arrangement is known as tristichous phyllotaxy. So three vertical rows are observed. Again, if we take another example, then this is the first leaf, this is the second leaf, this is the third leaf, this is the fourth leaf, this is the fifth leaf, again this is the sixth leaf. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So first will be overlapped by fifth, then ninth, then second will be overlapped by sixth and tenth. Third will be overlapped by seventh in the same way. Fourth will be overlapped by eighth. So vertically, if we view it, four vertical rows of leaves will be observed. That is known as tetratristichous. and so on. So these are the few types of alternate or spiral phyllotaxy. Now there is a term that is genetic spiral. Now what is this genetic spiral? If we move up from a leaf in a spiral manner, till a leaf comes exactly above the first one, this is a spiral or genetic spiral. One spiral is completed. Now in this case, phyllotaxy is written by taking the number of circles as numerator and number of leaves as denominator. So this is the way of writing a phyllotaxy, and this is known as Schimper-Brown series. For example, for alternate phyllotaxy, we can write that 1 by 2. For Tristicus spirometry, we can write 1 by 3. And it can be further increased to various types. It can be 2 by 5. It can be 5 by 13. It can be even 8 by 21, etc. So all these sequences are known as Schimper-Brown series. There is another term, that is angular divergence. Angular divergence is the angle between two leaves. It is the angle between two leaves and is calculated by phyllotaxy multiplied by 360 degree. For example, in case of alternate phyllotaxy, the angle between two leaves will be 180 degree. If we take another example of 2 by 5, if the phyllotaxy is 2 by 5, then it has to be multiplied by 360 and it come out to be 144 degree. So these are few examples of calculating the angular divergence. So this is the spiral phyllotaxy or alternate phyllotaxy. In next video, we'll discuss the other two types of phyllotaxy, that is opposite and whorled. Thanks for watching this video.